We want our AI models smaller, faster, and efficient, but they are just getting larger, slower, and full of redundancy and inefficiencies. Let me tell you in 3 minutes, how can OpenVINO help you? OpenVINO has many features targeted to accelerate large language models. Let's talk about dynamic quantization, weight compression, and KV caching. OpenVINO tools can perform all kinds of quantizations, basically taking model parameters represented in floating point wide range and quantize them to a smaller range. Here, for example, from plus minus 10 to the power of 38 at floating point 32 to plus minus 127 or 8 in int 8. This will significantly reduce the model size and help improve the performance. Link to the full documentation below. If the numbers you're trying to quantize are distributed like that, very close to each other, or like that, very much apart, the quantization factors will look totally different. Or if the numbers are mostly negative or mostly positive, it's obvious that the more you know about the weights, the operations, and even the input data, the better quantization you can perform. So why not quantize during runtime when you really have all the data in hand? Dynamic quantization is the default choice if you're running OpenVINO using Optimum OpenVINO. Or you can set it up using one line of code if you're using OpenVINO native API. You can read more about it in the link below. Second is weight compression. The weights are usually larger than the activations, so compressing the weights makes a huge difference. You can see here examples of the size reduction of few models, link below. Please see my other video on weight compression. You can basically grab a model from Hugging Face and compress the weights in one line of Optimum CLI code. If you're using Hugging Face, Optimum OpenVINO, or using one line of code if you're using native OpenVINO Python API. And last, KV caching or stateful model execution. A typical LLM is trained to generate the next token or the next word in the sentence. When it outputs a new word, it basically concatenates it to the original prompt and use a prompt plus the new word as an input to the next iteration and so on. So in this example, the words "the sun is" will be calculated again and again, definitely a redundant operation. If we look at the heart of the transformer-based architecture and to the self-attention mechanism, each token corresponds to an embedding vector. The embedding vector is multiplied by a matrix to create the vector Q query that basically represents the input token that is currently being processed. We also multiply the embedding by another matrix to create K, key, which is the matrix that represents the previous context, the previous tokens that the model should attend to, and the same for V, but it's applied after the softmax layer. These three elements, Q, K, and V, are sort of being multiplied to create the attention. But looking deeper into what's happening, we are only generating one word at a time. K and V contains information on all the words sequenced, but Q holds information only for the last token, so multiplying Q by K sort of generate the attention between the current token to all the previous ones. Since we are generating one token at a time, a new Q vector each time, the K and V matrices do not change much between the iterations. In this example, the word sun, for example, corresponds to a column at K and a row at V. These values will not change much as new tokens fly in. So instead of recalculating these values, we can just store them in the cache and save a lot of compute. And this is all very easy to implement with OpenVINO. Details in the link below. If you're using Optimum Intel, when you use the OpenVINO model for causal LM class, the model is transformed into a stateful form by default for optimization. If you're using OpenVINO API, you even have finer grain control over the execution, but you will have to define it yourself. Please check the sample code in the link below. If you're using OpenVINO model server, it also supports stateful model serving. Another link below. And here is a simple demonstration. I'm running the OpenVINO notebook Stable Sapphire's 3 billion chatbot, getting the libraries and installing. And here I'm getting the stateful model. Using this convert script, I'm selecting the device to be my Intel GPU A770. I'm getting first the stateless model. I'm using the convert script and disable stateful. And using the benchmark script to check the performance. 62 milliseconds for inference on my discrete GPU. And now for the stateful model with KV caching, and I'm down to 26 milliseconds, half the time per inference. Looking at the memory utilization, you can see how the memory footprint is smaller in the lower graph. KV caching save you here just a little amount of RAM memory, but wow, 2x the performance time. Not bad. So running large, very large models faster with smaller memory footprint using dynamic quantization, weights compression, or KV caching. Try it out. Subscribe. Thank you.